Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Dentistry Made Easy. The topic for today is acute necrotizing ulcerative gingivitis from periodontology. Now this is a very important topic from your exam point of view also and in general also. So the first point is the definition. It is an endogenous oral infection that is characterized by necrosis of gingival tissue. So endogenous is nothing but something that is originating internally. So it is the endogenous oral infection, something that is originating internally, that type of oral infection that is characterized by necrosis of gingival tissue. Necrosis is nothing but it is the localized death of the living cells because of the interruption of the blood supply. So this is the definition, it is the oral infection that is characterized by necrosis of the gingival tissues, and it is also known as trench mouth, Vincent gingivitis, pseudomembranous angina, fusus spirochetal gingivitis, because it's the organism that causes this. Etiology is bacteria, local predisposing factors, systemic predisposing factor, and psychomatic factors. So bacteria that causes this anag is fusiform bacilli and spirochetal organisms. So this is the main organism that causes anag. The local predisposing factors can be smoking. If there is injury to gingiva due to various reasons, then there can be pre-existing gingivitis. If that person is having pre-existing gingivitis, then it can lead to anag. The systemic can be nutritional deficiency. It can be deficiency of vitamin C and B2. And debilitating diseases like cancer, syphilis, if there is severe gastrointestinal disorders, it can lead to anag. And the other causes can be stress, psychological disturbance, and if there are more increased adrenocortical secretions. So this is in general why anag is caused. So this is the etiology of it. Now the etiopathogenesis is if there is stress and anxiety. So because of that, there is more corticosteroid production. Because of more corticosteroid, there will be immunosuppression. So immunosuppression, it causes increased bacterial growth, and which leads to necrotizing ulcerative gingivitis. So this is one way, because of stress. Then there can be viral infection. Because of this viral infection, there can be again immunosuppression, which again leads to increased bacterial growth, and finally it leads to anag. Then there can be pre-existing gingivitis. Then the other can be if there is nutritional deficiency of vitamin B2 and C, there again there can be immunosuppression, which leads to anag. Now if anag is not treated, it leads to necrotizing ulcerative periodontitis. It's the most severe case, and if it is not treated, then it lastly leads to necrotizing stomatitis. So this is the etiopathogenesis of it. The next part is the clinical features. The clinical features is age. It is commonly seen between 16 to 30 years, and it is seen in children in low socioeconomic groups. The symptoms, what the patient says, they complain of unpleasant fetid odor. So mal odor. The next is there is loss of taste sensation. Then there can be gingival bleeding as there is necrosis. The onset is sudden with pain. There can be tenderness. This pain. So there can be profuse salivation and metallic taste. So the taste, it turns out to be metallic. The taste is not good. The taste sensation has lost. Then the patient, he complains of constant radiating guanine type of pain that is intensified by spicy or hot food. Basically, there's the main symptom that the patient sees is pain. Now, the clinical features. In clinical features, the signs, what we are seeing. So, there can be blunting of interdental gingiva. Then, the gingiva is superficially stained with brown color. So, there can be staining with the brown color. Then, there is slight extrusion of the teeth, and they are sensitive to pressure. Extrusion is nothing but they come out of the socket. There is slight extrusion of the teeth. They're coming out of the socket. Like for this, they're coming a bit out of the socket. So the teeth are slightly movable and the patient is unable to eat properly. Because of this, the teeth, they are movable and the patient is unable to eat. Now how do they appear? So the lesion, it consists of necrotic punched out crater like ulcerations which develop on marginal and interdental gingiva. So on the margins and interdentally, there are these ulcerations which are seen, and they are of necrotic punched out crater like ulcerations. So these are crater. Crater is nothing but like a hollow space. So they are the necrotic punched out craters. So necrotic. Then the surface of gingiva is covered by grayish pseudomembrane slough. So they can be this grayish pseudomembranous slough. Then in some cases, ulcerations may develop on the cheek, lips, tongue and palate. The other features can be the patient may have high fever, increased pulse rate, decreased appetite, then generalized lassitude and regional lymphadenopathy. So they are the other symptoms which the patients may suffer from when they are having this, that is the systemic complications of this. Now the histopathology is, the lesion, it involves both the epithelium and the underlying connective tissue. Then the surface, so this lesion is including both things, epithelium and the connective tissue. So the epithelium, it is destroyed and it is replaced by the pseudomembranous mesh like fibrin. So the membrane, so the epithelium is destroyed and it is replaced by necrotic epithelial cells, then neutrophils, and this appear as surface pseudomembrane. Now the underlying connective tissue is hyperemic with numerous capillaries and dense infiltration of the PMN, and this clinically appears as surface pseudomembrane. So this is the surface epithelium, is like it appears as a surface pseudomembrane in histopathologically, and the connective tissue, it appears clinically as surface pseudomembrane. As we have said, in the appearance it has this gray pseudomembranous slough. So because of this connective tissue, it appears that. Now the zones of Anag. Lisgarten, he has described four zones as following. The first zone is the bacterial zone. Second is the neutrophil rich zone. Third is the necrotic zone. And fourth is the zone of spirochetal infiltration. So there are these four zones which were described by Lisgarten. So the first zone is the bacterial zone. Bacterial, it is most superficial type of zone and it contains bacteria, and which includes few spirochetes. So the, in first zone, there's this, as the name says, bacterial zone. So it contains various type of bacteria, but there are less number of spirochetes. The next one is the neutrophil rich zone. So neutrophil rich means it contains numerous leukocytes. Necrotic, it contains dead tissue cells, remnants of the connective tissue fragments, and numerous spirochetes. And the last zone is the zone of spirochetal. So, as the name says, so there are more number of spirochetes in this. So these are the four zones which you'll see histopathologically. Then what are the complications or fate of Anag? Systemic complications are very minimum. The patient may have local lymphadenopathy, fever in initial stages. But in advanced stages, he will have high fever, loss of appetite, increased pulse rate, increase in the WBC count. So because of fever, you'll see increase in WBC count. And if this is not treated, then it may progress into necrotizing ulcerative periodontitis with destruction of periodontium. So if it is not treated, it is leading to NUP, that is your necrotizing ulcerative periodontitis. So how is this progression? So the clinical course of the disease by Pinberg et al., it was like, first there is erosion of only the tip of interdental papilla. So only the tip of interdental papilla was included. But in stage 2, marginal gingiva is also included. In stage 3, it is like it involves the attached gingiva too over here. And last one is a stage 4, that is there can be exposure of the bone. But the progression which was given by Horning and Cohen, it was divided into the 7 stages. So the stage 1 is there is necrosis of pulp of tip of the papilla. Then stage 2 is necrosis of the entire papilla. So firstly, you'll see only the tip of the papilla which is necrosed. Then entire papilla, you'll see it is necrosed. And this is NUG, and the entire papilla is known as NUG or NUP. That is your necrotizing ulcerative periodontitis. Stage 3 is when there is necrosis of the marginal gingiva. So your marginal gingiva, near the margins of the gingiva, there is necrosis which is known as NUP, that is your necrotizing ulcerative periodontitis. So it is progressing more. So this is the complication of fate of your Anag if it is not treated. And stage 4 is necrosis of the attached gingiva. So now your attached gingiva is included. Stage 5 is necrosis of the buccal or the labial mucosa. So now your mucosa is also included, and that is known as necrotizing stomatitis. After that, there is necrosis of this alveolar bone, which is known as again necrotizing stomatitis. And if this is not treated, finally you'll see this case in which there is necrosis of the perforating skin of the cheeks. Over here, as you can see, this is the necrosis of the perforating cheeks, and that is known as noma, which is completely like necrosed area of your of the cheeks also. Then what is like how you'll diagnose it? So the diagnosis is based on the clinical findings of the gingival pain, ulceration, necrosis and bleeding. So the diagnosis, it is way too obvious. If you know how it appears, then you can easily diagnose it. So the diagnostic feature in ANAG can be gingival pain. So in this, the pain is constant radiating type of pain, and it is intensified by eating spicy or hot food. There is ulceration. Ulceration, it appears as a punched out crater-like depressions at the crest of the interdental papilla. And there is bleeding, spontaneous gingival bleeding. And this is the diagnostic features of ANAG. Now the treatment plan. So treatment plan, it is divided into two types, like depending upon two type of patients. So first is the treatment for non-ambulatory patients, and treatment for the other one is treatment for ambulatory patients. So non-ambulatory patients are those which have those systemic complications, and ambulatory is like they have only the ANAG, but they don't have symptoms of like they don't have systemic complications. So for the non-ambulatory patients, patients with symptoms of generalized systemic complications are the non-ambulatory patients. So on day one, so it is divided into various days, the treatment. So the first day, local treatment is generally limited to gently removing the necrotic pseudomembrane with a pallet of cotton. So you're just removing that pseudomembranous necrotic pad with a cotton. And then you're advising bed rest with, and you're asking the patient to rinse the mouth every 2 hours with diluted hydrogen peroxide. So now hydrogen peroxide is the treatment for your ANAG, like whatever the case is, if it is non-ambulatory or ambulatory, you should remember you are giving hydrogen peroxide for this ANAG patients. So you have to remember this 3% hydrogen peroxide, that this word, it should come into our answers. The next is systemic antibiotics like penicillins or metronidazoles can be given. Then on day two, on day one, you just remove that. You ask the patient to take bed rest, and you are just asking the patient to rinse the mouth with hydrogen peroxide. On day two, if the condition is improved, then you are proceeding to periodontal procedures, that is the treatment for ambulatory patients. Now we are going to see what are the treatment for ambulatory. If there is no improvement at the end of 24 hours, a bedside visit should be made. Then the treatment again, it includes gentle swab of the area with hydrogen peroxide. And day three is, in most cases, the condition will be improved. Then you have to start the treatment for the ambulatory patients. So non-ambulatory is basically you are having the symptoms of generalized systemic complications. So these are the like extra treatment modalities which you need to do for non-ambulatory patient. And when the symptoms of this, it decreases, then you have to shift the patient for the ambulatory treatment. So that is, on now it is divided into various visits, like 5 visits the patient need to do. On the first day, first visit, there is this topical LA is applied, and after 2 to 3 minutes, the areas are gently swabbed with a cotton pallet to remove the pseudomembrane. So basically, this is the first thing for the ambulatory patients, and the patients which are coming from non-ambulatory, and then they are shifting to the ambulatory. So on visit one, so basically you are giving topical LA, and after that you are removing with a cotton pallet that pseudomembrane area. After the area is cleansed with warm water, the superficial calculus is removed with ultrasonic scalers. Then the calculus is removed with the scalers. Subgingival scaling and curettage are contraindicated at this time because of the possibility of extending the infection to the deeper tissues. So you're not advising the patient, like the patients are not advised to get their subgingival scaling done, because the infection, it may get into the deeper tissues. Then the patients with moderate or severe ANAG and local lymphadenopathy, they are placed on antibiotic therapy. And the antibiotic therapy is penicillin V, that is given 500, the dose is 500 mg thrice daily for 7 days. The next one is metronidazole 400 mg twice daily for 7 days. Then the instructions that are to be given to the patients are, he need to avoid smoking and alcohol. Then rinse with 3% hydrogen peroxide and warm water for every 2 hours. Then confine the tooth brushing to the removal of surface debris with the blend dentrify. So this is the instruction that I'll be given to the patients on visit 2. So scaling and curettage, now scaling and curettage can be done. Shrinkage of gingiva may expose previously covered calculus, and the advice the patient the instruction of the previous visit. Now again, you have to instruct the patient all these three instructions again for the visit 2. Visit 3 is scaling and root planing are repeated. Then plaque control instructions are given. Hydrogen peroxide is discontinued. Now, till your visit 2, the patient was taking hydrogen peroxide. Now on visit 3, so hydrogen peroxide is now discontinued. Then visit 4 is oral hygiene instructions are reinforced and thorough scaling and root planing are performed at this stage. And last is the visit 5, appointments are fixed for the treatment of elimination of all the local irritants, periodontal pockets, then pericoronal flaps, then patient is put on maintenance program. So it is like you are eliminating all the other things on visit 5. If there are pockets, if the patient needs to be done for the periodontal flap surgeries, and everything is done in the visit 5 stage. So this is the treatment for ambulatory patients, and this is also the treatment for non-ambulatory patient. But after that 3 days visit, after that, the patient is transferred to this treatment for ambulatory. The other treatment consideration can be supportive treatment, nutritional supplements, and mouth rinsing. So supportive is when the patient is told to have more fluids. Then there is consumption of the nutritional supplements. Then there is administration of nutritional supplements, and bed rest is necessary. Nutritional supplements is patient is placed on balanced diet, and there is intake of water-soluble vitamin B and C. Because the etiology, one of the etiological factor was nutritional deficiency. What that was your deficiency of vitamin B and C. So because of that, the patient is asked to take more vitamins B and C. Then the mouth rinsing is 0.12% chlorhexidine is given. Like they are asked to rinse their mouth with 0.12% chlorhexidine twice a day. Then mouth rinsing every 2 hours with warm water plus hydrogen peroxide 3%. Is mandatory in the patients of ANAG. So hydrogen peroxide is like the main treatment for the ANAG patients. So this was the supportive type of treatment, other treatment considerations which are to be done in the patients of ANAG. And that was it of this video. I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you so much.